theaters, not net.
Leaving paradise seems to be the devil's speciality. Not only was he cast out as an abominable branch and fell to earth like lightning, but he also tempted Eve in the garden of paradise to rebel against God, who was likewise banished alongside her husband Adam. How strange it is then to have the first teaser trailer of the PG-13 film Barbie, directed by Greta Gerwig, referenced the film 2001 A Space Odyssey by Stanley Kubrick and Arthur C. Clarke. To the uninitiated and profane, such a teaser would indeed seem peculiar, but to those whose eyes are not wide shut, this trailer is the perfect encapsulation of the nature of this feature film. The late William Cooper introduces his Mystery Babylon series with a detailed explanation of the Luciferian symbolism embedded in the opening sequence of 2001's The Dawn of Man. In short, this sequence represents humanity's contact with the embodiment of Lucifer, the monolith, the bright light of reason slash intellect that mystically delivers us from the bonds of ignorance to a future of godhood where we transcend space and time.
You know what he's thinking? I'm God. That's what he's thinking. I'm God. I'm God. I have the power. I am the leader. Don't mess with me because I know something that you don't know.
It's really incalculable.
This Luciferian ideology is continued in the 2001 book series by Arthur C. Clarke, as the planet Jupiter transforms into Lucifer, and better personified in the earlier work, Childhood's End, where devils reveal themselves as man's global liberators to usher in
the false industrial revolution.
The plot of the Barbie film as described on IMDb, which has now been updated, used to say this: to live in Barbie land is to be a perfect being in a perfect place, unless you have a full-on existential crisis, or you're a Ken. Which sounds a lot like Ezekiel 28:15 when describing the devil. You were the anointed cherub who covers, I established you, you were on the holy mountain of God. You walked back and forth in the midst of the fiery stones. You were perfect in your ways from the day you were created till iniquity was found in you. The main trailer of the feature film depicts Barbie asking the character played by Kate McKinnon,
what do I have to do?
When questioning her own mortality. With the reply,
you have to go to the real world.
Barbie is then presented with a dichotomy. Continue in ignorance or eat the forbidden fruit and be like God himself, knowing ultimate reality. Barbie then leaves paradise, Barbieland, with Adam, Ken. The antagonist played by Will Ferrell is on a mission to put Barbie back in her box or bring her back to paradise. At this point, we can only assume that Mr. Ferrell is playing the role of God whom Barbie will rebel against. This feature film cost more than $100 million to produce. And I'm sure AAA budget feature films with dedicated continuity professionals on and off set would overlook visuals that would draw clear lines between the biblical depiction of the devil to Barbie, right? I guess Barbie likes winking. It's not like there's a universal religion that has birthed all secular societies that has an obsession with covering eyes or anything. So strange. Or the fact the Bible describes the physical attributes of the embodiment of the devil himself, the Antichrist, as having a wounded and blinded right eye in Zechariah 11:17. And I'm sure it's just another $100 million coincidence that the temptress of Barbie is clad in snakeskin boots while having her right eye marked. Nice Genesis 3:15 flex. Perhaps this one is a bit of a stretch, but is it not strange that on a movie poster, Barbie is depicted as a criminal who stands 5 feet 6 inches with the 5 being cropped out depicting 666? For a film with a PG-13 rating and aimed at children, there sure are some strange references to bizarre adult themes and sexuality. There, I fixed it. Or this strong, independent woman of color girl boss President Barbie who divulges that playing with Ken as a child was her, quote, sex education.
I love Ken, honestly. That was my sex education.
Ooh.
So Ken was, you know, very handsy.
Or the admission that Barbie is a social engineering tool to get little girls to imagine themselves as materialistic narcissists who live without the influence of fathers, husbands, or pastors.
She can put on a suit and she's a lawyer. She can put on a space helmet and she's an astronaut. She can do all these things, and she was doing it back in a time when women couldn't even have their own bank accounts. And she owned her own car and she owned her own house. And she had a cute boyfriend, but he was kind of like an accessory. There's always been outrage around Barbie. She was the first woman doll. Suddenly, like, little girls are playing with a doll and people are like, I guess they're imagining that they could be a woman, but that's not all they were imagining. They were imagining having their own house, having their own car, having their own careers. You have to imagine that that had some sort of impact.
And Barbie's boyfriend, Ken, he's an accessory among her other material possessions. What a wonderful message to be communicating to little girls who will turn out to be embittered cat lady Karens in 30 years as society goes down the progressive toilet. You see, pop culture seems to be all too eager to present the devil as a woman who liberates humanity. And where's Prada? Notice how Lucifer emanates from the 2001 style monolith as a woman in the Pendulum song Witchcraft. You'll also notice that their eyes are covered. Strange. How about Billie Eilish embodying Lucifer and admitting that through chaos people will side with the devil?
My Lucifer is lonely, 'cause even God herself has enemies, and once the water starts to rise and heaven's out of sight, she'll want the devil on her team. My Lucifer is lonely.
And more recently by Cloudy June with a smash hit song, The Devil is a Woman.
If the devil is a woman,
here's a shocker. Notions of the devil being presented as a woman is common in the occult, such as the Theosophical Society. The opening of the 1887 Theosophical magazine titled Lucifer features a poem by Gerald Massey depicting the devil as the Lady of Light. Shine with transfiguring might, till earth shall reflect back as human thy likeness, celestial woman. Lucifer, Lady of Light. The connection between Luciferianism / Satanism and feminism is well documented in the book titled Satanic Feminism, Lucifer as the Liberator of Woman in the 19th Century Culture by Pura Faxneld. Faxneld comments on this positive view of the devil among theosophists. Blavatsky's view of the fall as a positive gnosis-bringing event thus implicitly becomes an upvaluation of woman. She is no longer responsible for mankind's fall into sin, but instead actively involved in the gaining of spiritual wisdom from the benevolent snake. Perhaps there were political feminist reasons for Blavatsky to view the fall thus. As a female religious leader bringing esoteric wisdom to mankind, she had every reason to want to smash the old negative view of Eve and the tree of wisdom. Like a good con artist, Blavatsky used deception to promote her religion, which was finally exposed by the stage magician John Neville Macklin in his short 1912 pamphlet Fraud of Modern Theosophy. His conclusion? A theory of government sedition to usher in a
post-industrial revolution.
I have no absolute proof that the society is seditious. Still, there is ample reason why the authorities should keep an eye upon it. Finally, it would be worth mentioning that one of the agendas of the Bavarian Illuminati, according to leaked letters exposed by John Robinson's 1798 publication, Proofs of a Conspiracy, was to secure political influence by mobilizing women in their cause by stirring up their resentment towards authority. There is no way of influencing men so powerfully as by means of the woman. These should therefore be our chief study. We should insinuate ourselves into their good opinion, give them hints of emancipation from the tyranny of public opinion, and of standing up for themselves. It will be an immense relief to their enslaved minds to be freed from any one bond of restraint, and will fire them the more, and cause them to work for us with zeal, without knowing that they do so, for they will only be indulging their own desire of personal admiration.
Ideas live forever.
I would venture to suggest that technocrats who understand the value of operant conditioning will use all their powers and influence to shape public opinion by destroying the old and inserting the new.
Down with the patriarchy. That's the message.
The family must go for a new order to arise from the ashes of chaos. Little girls must grow up thinking that they have been oppressed by their fathers and must in turn dominate their future effeminate husbands under the guise of equality and inclusion. Men must be trained to be lovers of pleasure, encouraged to be weak, submissive, and cowardly, as to not resist in any way the forces of evil that seek to dominate society. Men must be Kens. Can't be a beta soy boy simp.
Look, I'm just trying to get you on the path. You say the God is love, you forget the other half. He is also wrath, get it right. And he is the creator, bet my bottom dollar he is not a beta.
The devil loves pride. Pride is celebrated by a culture that has turned its back on God. Read Romans 1:18-32. Pride is the root of all rebellion and is manifested in humanity worshipping the creature, Lucifer, rather than the creator, God, who is blessed forever.
Amen.
The inversion of virtues as vice and vice as virtues in modern entertainment is therefore deliberate. Follow Ken, the first Adam who rebelled against God and failed to protect his bride, or Christ, the second Adam who laid down his life so that she may live. Will you follow the devil out of paradise or God towards it? The choice is yours.